going on, everybody? Andrew Thompson here. I'm currently here with Joy Janela. Joy, how you doing today, man?
Hey, man, I'm doing pretty good. Starrcast is always a good time. This is the fourth edition. It's always a delight to be around here and see the fans and stuff. And, you know, the live stage shows are great. And it's just cool. Everyone just getting drunk and having a good time.
So tell me about your thoughts about the response from you and Kenny Omega's dark match that eventually led to you guys having a TV match on Dynamite.
Yeah, the response was crazy. Actually, we were supposed to have a straight-up regular match on Dark, nothing too crazy. And I got a call the night before from Tony Khan, changing it to the fuckfest that it became. And me and Kenny, we went 30 minutes, which wasn't supposed to be the case. And, you know, it was kind of a big match for me. And one of the main reasons I signed to AEW was to wrestle Kenny Omega. And I got it so soon, and it came so sudden, you know, because I just found out that week that I was wrestling him. And, you know, we did it, and then we went to TV the next week, and we did it again. And I look forward to wrestling him on a pay-per-view in the future and having a big match with him.
Can you just talk to me about what has it been like for you to see the growth of GCW and for you to be the part of that?
GCW is growth that I compare it a lot to the growth of ECW in the 90s, and it's just a huge cult following, and now it's expanding outside of the cult following, and they're selling out buildings from coast to coast, anywhere they go, Nashville, Los Angeles, they're going to Texas soon, everywhere, they're selling out buildings, and spring break is coming up, WrestleMania weekend this year, and we got 5,000 seats to sell, and I no doubt in my mind that we're going to sell out all those seats. That's a game changer right there for sure.
One thing I did want to talk to you about, what I really appreciate about GCW, is the show they put it on called For The Culture, and it's a show based around African-American talents.
Yes.
Can you speak about that and just how aware GCW is that a show like that could be in great demand?
Oh, it's awesome. AJ Gray and Brett Lauderdale came up with the idea to do this show for the culture, and I think it's going to be steal the weekend. I think it's going to be the best show of WrestleMania weekend. I think last year Orange Cassidy, his show with GCW, was kind of the sleeper show stealer of the weekend. I think For The Culture this year is going to be, everyone's coming there to perform at their their highest skill and degree, and it's going to be a very memorable show for everyone.
While in AEW, you got a chance to show your technical side that you do in the ring. Was that something important to you, or was that really nothing that you wanted to prove to anybody, but you knew within yourself that you could do that?
Yeah, I've been doing technical wrestling for a while now. I've had matches on the indies with the Riddles, the Zack Sabre Jr.'s of the world, 30-minute match with Zack Sabre Jr. a couple years ago in Connecticut. And people on the indies know I can wrestle because I've done it all in front of these fans. But the new fans coming into AEW see me for the first time, saw me as some kind of hardcore car accident, fuckfest, fucking fall off the ladder and kill yourself wrestler, which is not the case. So now it's me doing the same thing after it happened with I got thrown off that building a few years ago, is prove people wrong on a larger scale and convert people and say, listen, this is not what I'm all about. I'm all the flavors of ice cream all rolled into one.
Well, one thing I did want to ask you is that your run as WWN Champion, you held that belt for about 5 months before you got injured. Yep. Were there any special memories from that title run?
I had a good my match with Austin Theory, it was like wrestling him and debuting for Evolve for the first time, and then him putting the belt on me right off the bat was very special to me. And I do appreciate Gabe for that, and a lot of those guys still, wrestling Darby, and that was probably my favorite match of my Evolve run, is wrestling Darby in Massachusetts. Such a talent, you know, one of my favorite guys to wrestle ever, and that's my favorite match of them, hands down, me and him in Evolve.